If you're building apps with Angular, you're probably using signals more and more every day. This can definitely be a challenge at times because it's such a different way of working. And there are things that just don't quite work with signals yet, like host binding, for example. Well, in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how we can actually use the host binding decorator with signals pretty easily right now, even though the decorator was not originally built to support them directly. All right, let's get to it. Okay, before we do anything, let's take a look at the example application we'll be working with in this video. Here we have a simple application with a list of items to complete. We can mark the items complete by clicking the button next to each step. And when all items have been marked complete, we display a message notifying the user that everything is done. And we'll see this in more detail soon, but this app is in the process of migrating to Signals. In this video, we're going to convert it over the rest of the way, and in the process, we'll need to update a host binding on our list items based on a signal input. Okay, first, let's familiarize ourselves with the existing code for this app. Let's start with the app component itself. Looking at the template, we can see that we have three instances of our list item component, one for each of the items to be completed. For each of the list items, we have a corresponding Boolean property for whether that step is complete or not. As you can see, these properties have already been converted over to signals. Now, when the button in each of these items is clicked, it toggles the complete property for that list item. And this value is passed as an input to the list item component. Here at the bottom of the template, once all the steps are complete, this message will display. So that's the app component, and since everything here has been converted to signals already, we don't need to do anything more here. So now let's look at the list item component. In this component, we still have two inputs using the old input decorator. First, we've got the input for the step number. Then we have the input for the isComplete property, which is also a host binding for a complete class. So when that input is true, the complete class will be added to the host, which is how it turns everything within it green. So the step property will be pretty easy to switch over to a signal input, but the isComplete property will be a little more challenging. Let's start with the step property. We can begin by removing the decorator. Then we just need to set it using the input function. And we'll need to make sure that function gets imported correctly too. Then we'll want to make it required, and we'll type it to a number. That's pretty much it. We just need to update the value in the template now that it's a signal. Now, if we save, everything should look the same. And it does. Nice. Now, at some point, the Angular team will probably have a native solution for signals with host bindings, but for the time being, we need to be a little clever. One way we could do it is we could use a getter function and simply return the value of the signal input in that function. That would work, but it would run more than it needs to. Instead, we can use an effect. This way, it will be optimized to only update when the value of the signal input has changed. And that's what we're going to do here. Okay, first, let's set our isComplete property to a Boolean input. Next, we need to add a new property for our class host binding. Let's call it hasComplete class. And let's initialize it to false. Now we can add the effect to update this property when the isComplete input value changes. To do this, we need to add a constructor first. Then we can add the effect function, and we need to make sure it gets imported properly from Angular Core. And within the callback, all we need to do is set our hasComplete class property to the value of the isComplete signal input. And that's all we need. Since we're using the effect function, it will run only when the isComplete value changes. Okay, last thing we need to do is remove the old input decorator import since we're no longer using it. Now we can save and verify everything is working correctly like it was before the change. So let's click on our buttons. Nice, everything looks the same, but it's all using signals now. So that's one way you can use signals and host binding for the time being. Like I said earlier though, at some point there will probably be an even better way to do this, but at least you have a pretty slick way to do it until that time comes. Hope that helps you as you build using signals. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.